If you're like me and you obsess about hot and cold spots around your house, but every time you try to bring it up with your significant other, you get this look, then forget about them and check this out. What do you think the front of this house has to do with these frigid infrared camera readings? Let's take a closer look.
Hey, how's it going? Today I'm doing a cantilever block and seal. I have kind of a unique opportunity. It's a really cold day. It's January 2025, and I'm going to take a few before pictures with the thermal camera, and then I'm going to be returning a little bit later today, and I'll take a few after once the area has been sealed and insulated, and we'll see, you know, what the difference is.
When Janet Snyder and her husband moved into their bi-level home in Columbia, Maryland, they had big plans. This was the home where they envisioned raising a family, building memories, and settling in for the long haul. But there was one glaring problem. The house was uncomfortably cold during the winter months, particularly in the areas adjacent to the front cantilever. Janet's office and a front bedroom were virtually unusable during the winter.
I could not walk around in those rooms without shoes.
All right, so once the work was done, let's take a look at the before picture I took. And I think this one was taken somewhere around 1 o'clock, maybe 1:15 p.m. The first thing I want to do is just punch in the cold spot in the image. And I'm going to do the whole image, and you can see that the cold spot there is about 50 degrees Fahrenheit. And let's go ahead and get a hot spot going here, and we can see where the hot spot is. And of course, that's on the inside of the house. And if you look down here, this is the reference picture. Somewhere on the bookshelf there, something's absorbed some of that heat in that room, and it's created the hot spot. And then the last thing I'll just do here is go through the average for the whole image. And let's pop that white just so we can see it. And the average for the image is 58.9. So that's not the temperature in the room or anything, but that is, you know, the average temperature of all the surfaces that this infrared image took. And it's a good, you know, way to just sort of set the bar on, okay, what's the before? 58.9 degrees Fahrenheit. And now let's take a look at the after. Whoa. All right, so obviously right here, maybe there's a tiny spot that we missed, but let's go ahead and do the same exercise. Let's get our cold spot for the whole image. And yep, boom, there it is, 54.5. So even the coldest spot in this entire image, which is basically the same as the other, is 54.5, and previously it was 50. Let's go ahead and get the hot spot. Here we have 67.5. Previously it was 64.5, so obviously it's warmed up, and this is a little bit later in the day and the sun has actually set. It's about 5:15 p.m. at this point in time. Excuse me, and let's go ahead and get the whole image. 65.7 for the entire image compared to 58.9, so that's substantial. You know, 7 degree increase in the overall temperature for this image. I would say that this particular project was a success.
So how did we do it? For that, you should check out a few of the other videos I have that demonstrate the process. One of my promises to Janet was to check the air sealing work in the crawl space. It was done by the previous owner, and she felt some cold air coming in. So that's what I did. After everything else was done, I fired up the blower door and went in. I found several places where I was able to improve the sealing around the insulation, and in the corner I found the problem and got it all sealed up. Later that evening, I shared before and after thermal images with Janet, showing the dramatic reduction in heat loss. Her response was immediate and heartfelt, a red heart emoji. If you're facing similar issues in your home, whether it's drafts, cold spots, or high energy bills, wherever you live, consider taking the first step with a home energy audit. As Janet's story shows, the right solutions can make all the difference. Besides, we can't all be experts in everything, and insulation can get a little tricky.